Everybody put your cameras on, children. Arjun, Srishti, Noel, Shaurya, Avika, Pratyush, Ritvik. Everyone put your cameras on and let's begin the class. Yes. We were doing chapter number 17. Children, where were we? Were we on Odisha, the state of Odisha?
No, ma'am.
Then?
And we have to start chapter 17.
We have to start. We haven't started yet.
Ma'am, no, we ma'am. Have to start.
Yeah. All right, okay. So everybody open up your books to page number 111.
Open it.
Each one of you open your books and your cameras too. I will only mark attendance of those whose cameras will be on.
Chapter 17.
Rishabh, mute yourself. All right, who is going to read first? Let's have Navira Salman. Navira Salman, you are going to read from the beginning, chapter 17. Start.
Okay, ma'am. Chapter 17, the peninsular region and the island. The Peninsular region, the peninsular plateau of India or the southern plateau is divided into two parts by the valley formed by the river Narmada, the Malwa plateau and the Chota Nagpur plateau. The Malwa plateau is located in the northwest and the Chota Nagpur plateau is located in the northeast of the peninsular plateau. The Malwa plateau lies between the Aravalli and Vindhya mountain range. Parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lie in the region. The river Chambal, Son and the Damodar flow through these regions. The
Chota Nagpur. All right, that's all. So children, what do we study here? What do we read here? We read here that the peninsular plateau itself has been divided into two regions. What are the names of those two regions or those two plateaus? Tell me, the plateau region, the peninsular plateau has been divided into two parts.
Ma'am, Chota Nagpur plateau and Malwa plateau.
Very nice. The Chota Nagpur plateau and Malwa plateau. Now we will study that the Chota Nagpur plateau comprises of some states, while the Malwa plateau comprises of some different states. So what are those states that fall under the Malwa plateau? Can you tell me? We have studied. Under Malwa plateau, what states do we have? Tell me.
Ma'am, please send the chapter 16. Answer these questions in detail.
Okay, I will send right now.
Question 3 and question 4.
Okay, beta, I will send please, right ma'am. Now. Should I leave this class, leave the chapter and send you the question answers? Yes. So which all states come under the Malwa plateau? Read in the paragraph and let me know.
Mom, can I tell?
Yes, Pratyush, tell.
Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lie in the region. The river Chambal, Son and Damodar flow through this region.
Okay. So if we talk about the states, we have some parts of Rajasthan and then Madhya Pradesh, which come under the Malwa Plateau. Now, when we move right hand side, that is the east, the eastern side, then we have the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Now, which all states come under the Chota Nagpur Plateau? That we will read. But can you see this half map of India? The map of
yes,
India.
Ma'am.
Krishav, stop making faces and look into your book. Can you see this map of India? Now,
yes,
here
ma'am.
In India, this half map of India, can you see the state of Madhya Pradesh? Yes. And
yes.
On the left-hand yes. side of Madhya Pradesh is which state in orange color? That's Rajasthan. Okay, that is
yes,
Rajasthan.
Ma'am.
So this orange color state and this Madhya Pradesh is a part of Malwa Plateau. Now, when we will move right-hand side, or I must say on the eastern side of this map, then that area is the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Okay? Advika Gupta, read out the
okay,
next
ma'am.
Paragraphs.
Ma'am, please tell the page number because
page,
I joined right now.
Page number 111.
Yes, ma'am.
Read out the next paragraph on page number 111.
Parts of Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh lies in this region. The river Chambal, Son and Damodar flow through this region. The Chota Nagpur Plateau comprises Jharkhand and the some part of Odisha.
Now underline this line. All of you underline this line. The Chota Nagpur Plateau comprises of which all states? Some parts of Odisha, Bihar and Chhattisgarh.
Women Jharkhand.
Yes, Jharkhand also. Now
the Deccan Plateau lies to the southern
south of Satpura Range. Now, after we have read about the Malwa Plateau and the Chota Nagpur Plateau, on the southern side, which plateau lies? On the southern side, we have the Deccan Plateau.
Deccan Plateau.
Yes, very nice. Then, Advika, continue.
It comprises part of Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. The river Mahanadi, Godavari, and Krishna flow through the Deccan Plateau. The Kaveri River flows from west to east into the Bay of Bengal. The Tapi and Narmada flow westward into the Arabian Sea.
Now,
ma'am, the chapter number 17.
Yes, Krishav, chapter number 17. You were busy with yourself, looking at yourself in the camera. You don't know which chapter we are doing. Yes, it comprises of parts of now when we talk about the Deccan Plateau, we have various other states that fall under the Deccan Plateau. Which are those states? They are the states of Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. These are all the states of which part? The southern part of India. Fine. Then, the rivers Mahanadi, Godavari, and Krishna flow through the Deccan Plateau. And the Kaveri River flows from west to east into the Bay of Bengal, while the Tapi and Narmada flow westwards into the Arabian Sea. Which are those two rivers that fall into the Arabian Sea?
Ma'am, Tapi and Narmada.
Ma'am, Tapi and Narmada.
Tapi and Narmada, they flow into the Arabian Sea, rest all the rivers, the major rivers that we have studied about, they fall into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, they all fall eastwards, while only Tapi and Narmada fall westwards. Then coming on to the state of Madhya Pradesh, Nihit Agarwal, read out Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, ma'am. Madhya Pradesh is a state located in central India. Bhopal is its capital city. Jalior, Indore, and Jabalpur are other important cities of Madhya Pradesh. The Marwari Hill Station and Kanha Tiger Reserve and
Bandhavgarh National Park
are some of the places of interest in Madhya Pradesh. The temples of Khajuraho are important monuments. The diamond mines at Panna are also located here. Cotton and wheat are the important crop of cultivation here.
That's all. So everybody now take a pencil in your hand and underline all the important lines of Madhya Pradesh. Now, which are those important lines of Madhya Pradesh? That it is located in central India. Children, as we know the name Madhya, what does Madhya means? Madhya means the center. So, Madhya Pradesh is the centralmost state if we look at the map of India. Is that so? Have you ever noticed this thing? Then, Bhopal is its capital city. What is the capital of Madhya Pradesh? It's
Ma'am Bhopal.
Yes, it's
Bhopal.
Then we have the diamond mines at Panna also located here. There is a place in Madhya Pradesh named Panna. What do we have there? We have the diamond mines located there in Panna. Then coming on to the state of Chhattisgarh, Ritvik Arora will read it.
Chhattisgarh is located in East Central India. Raipur is its capital city. This state is mainly located along the Mahanadi River basin. The source of the Mahanadi River is near Raipur. Chhattisgarh has a varied landscape with many valleys. Indravati, Arpa, and Pairia are some of the important rivers. The state experiences hot, dry, and windy summers and heavy rainfall during the rainy seasons. The state is rich in minerals such as coal, iron, and bauxite. Meaning agriculture, energy production, and manufacturing are the main industries of Chhattisgarh. The Bhilia steel plant that produces steel rails is located in Bhilia in Chhattisgarh. The major crops grown here are rice and maize.
All right. Then what do we study in the state of Chhattisgarh? What is the capital of Chhattisgarh, children?
Ma'am, Raipur.
Raipur.
And what is this state rich in? What is the state of Chhattisgarh rich in?
Mem in diamonds mines.
Mineral. Yes. Any Mem other answer?
Mem in mineral.
Yes. This state is rich in minerals. Now, which are those minerals? It's coal, iron, and bauxite. And the Bhilai steel plant. The Bhilai steel plant is the biggest producer of steels that is located in this state. The largest producer of steel in India is located in the state of Chhattisgarh. And what is the name? It's the Bhilai steel plant. What is the name of the place where it is located? The name of the place is also Bhilai. Okay, underline these lines, children. They are very important. Mining, agriculture, energy. Energy production and manufacturing are the main industries of Chhattisgarh. You have to underline all these lines and have to learn them. You have to remember that which state is famous for what? Which state is known for what? Then coming on to the state of Jharkhand. Page number 112. Coming on to the state of Jharkhand. Now, Noel. Noel, are you there? Noel.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, read out the state of Jharkhand.
Okay, ma'am. Jharkhand. Jharkhand is located in the northeastern part of India. Ranchi is its capital. It was carved out of Bihar in the year 2000. Most of Jharkhand falls under the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Jharkhand is almost entirely covered by plateaus, hills, and valleys. The two main plateaus are
Hazaribagh and Ranchi.
Hazaribagh and Ranchi. They are separated by the river Damodar. The Subarnarekha and the Brahmani and the Son are the other rivers that run through this state. Jharkhand has a huge forest cover.
All right.
Bokaro and Ranchi are some of the important industrial towns of Jharkhand.
Underline this line. All of you underline this line. Then continue.
They are known for steel production. The state also has a flourishing agricultural sector. Dhanbad is also an important city in the state.
All right. Now, when we see the state of Jharkhand, when we read about the state of Jharkhand, we know that it is located in which part? The northeast part of India. What is the capital of Jharkhand?
Ranchi.
Ma'am, Ranchi.
Ranchi is the capital of Ranchi is the capital of Jharkhand. And Jharkhand, now it is a separate and individual state. Earlier, in which state used to Jharkhand come? It was a part of which state before being carved out, before being an independent state?
And Bihar.
Yes. Jharkhand was a part of Bihar only. It is only in
Bihar.
Yes, Jharkhand is a part of Bihar. It is only in year 2000 that Jharkhand was carved out of Bihar and it was made a separate state, an independent state. You have to underline these lines, the ones I'm speaking out. These are very important. Then, the state of Jharkhand has got two plateaus. Which are those two plateaus? Hazaribagh and Ranchi.
Chota Nagpur Plateau.
Which are those two plateaus in Jharkhand? Hazaribagh and Ranchi.
And Ranchi.
Which are some important towns, some industrial towns of Jharkhand? We have some very important towns in Jharkhand. They are Jamshedpur, Bokaro, and Ranchi.
Ranchi.
And this state is also known for steel production. Now, children, when we study about these plateau region states, so what is this plateau region rich in? We are studying in all the states. It is rich in the production of minerals and of steel. What do we find there? The plateau region wholesale is rich in the production of minerals.
Minerals and steel.
Yes, very nice.
Minerals and tea.
Yes. Okay, now moving forward to the state of Orissa.
Ma'am, I can read.
Yes, Tanmay, read.
Odisha is located in northern India. Bhumeshwar.
Is it northern? Just read. What is it? Northeastern.
Northeastern.
Bhumeshwar is its capital city.
Cuttack
and Puri are the other big towns. Paradip is the port. The famous Jagannath temple is in Puri, where the annual
Rath Yatra
Filigree. Rath Yatra is held on Odisha, is known as its silver work called filigree, and textiles, rice and jute are main crops grown.
Harikud
Dam is built on Mahanadi River that flows through the state. The classical dance Odisha belong to this state,
Lake Chilka,
a home of for imaginary birds, lies along the coast.
Lies along the coastal plains. Now, children, what do we study about this state? That this state is the famous Jagannath temple is located in this state, and Orissa is also known for its silver work filigree. Do you know what is this filigree work? Does anyone know? Okay. Then we have, what is the capital of Orissa? Tell me, what is the capital of Orissa?
Bhubaneswar.
And
coastal plains.
Yes. And what is Lake Chilka? Lake Chilka, it is a home of what?
Birds.
Home of migratory birds. What is the meaning of migratory birds? Do you know that?
Migratory birds.
What is migratory? What is the meaning to migrate? All right. Migrate means to move from. Yes.
Ma'am, to move from one place to another to live.
Yes, very nice. Migration means to move from one place to another. So these birds also move from one place to another. Why? Why do they move? Just to have a good weather. Now, when it is very cold, what happens? These birds move to a place where they can survive. where
it yes, is, ma'am, I see in the sky.
Yes, where they can survive. So these are, this is Lake Chilka is a home to what? Migratory birds. Then the Hirakud Dam. You have all heard about how you have all heard this name Hirakud Dam, right? Have you or not? No, you no, haven't. Ma'am. All right. No, so the Hirakud Dam. Underline these lines, children. Hirakud Dam is built on the river Mahanadi, which is in this state. This river, Mahanadi River, flows through this state. So we have Hirakud Dam built on it. Now, children, if we see the filigree work, what is this filigree work? I'm going to share screen with you. Just have a look how beautiful this work is. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now see this metal work, these cuttings and carvings. Can you see all of them? How beautiful
yes,
it
ma'am.
Is. This is what, this is yes, the ma'am. Silver filigree work. The work is so integrate and so minute. It is so beautifully done. See, these are the show pieces. We have jewelry also. We have so many other things that they have filigree work on. See? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, coming back to the chapter, let's study about the state of Maharashtra.
Can I read?
Yes, read out.
Maharashtra extends from Shadri range to Patan. Other important towns are.
Who is reading? I am not even being able to figure out who is reading. Is it Adeshika who is reading or it's Krishna who is reading?
No, ma'am, I am not reading.
But I told Krishna to read. Why is Adeshika reading? I told Krishna read.
Krishna, read out. Maharashtra extends from the Sadri range of the western sea. Is the capital of other important towns of Nagpur, Pune.
Okay, children, wait. I think there is some major issue with your networks today. Your signals are very weak and it's not coming. The voice is not coming very clear. Pratyush Pal, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, read out the state of Maharashtra.
Maharashtra extends from the Sahyadri range to the western sea coast. Mumbai is the capital. Other important towns are Nagpur, Pune, Aurangabad and Nasik. The Godavari and the Krishna River flow through this state. This state is the largest producer of cotton in India. Other crops like sugarcane, grapes and banana are also grown. Alfonso, mango and orange from Nagpur are famous fruit of the region. People speak Marathi. The most popular festival of the state is Ganesh Chaturthi. The tourist attractions are Ajanta and Ellora Caves, Elephant, Mahabaleshwar and Pajgani. The state has many important industries like automobile, textiles and electronics. The Indian film industry, Bollywood, is in Mumbai.
Okay, very nice. Very well read, Pratyush. Now we study that Maharashtra extends from the Sahyadri range to the western coast. Mumbai is the capital. What is the capital of Maharashtra?
Mumbai.
Yes. And other important towns of Mumbai. Maharashtra are
Nagpur, Pune,
Aurangabad. Ma'am, Pune, Aurangabad, Nasik.
And Nasik. These are the important towns of Maharashtra. Then we have the most popular festival is the state in this state is which festival is
Ganesh Chaturthi.
Yes. The tourist attractions are Ajanta and Ellora Caves, Elephanta, Mahabaleshwar, and Panchgani. How many of you have seen Ajanta and Ellora Caves? Have you been? Yes or no? No.
No.
So let's have a visit to famous Ajanta and Ellora Caves also. I'm going to share screen with you. Just have a look how they look like. Can you see, children?
Ma'am, is not coming on my screen.
Okay, it will come. Wait.
Ma'am, it is come.
It has come?
Ma'am, it is. Yes, ma'am.
These are Ajanta and Ellora Caves. Now, they attract tourists from so many different places. Can you see, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Okay, coming back to the chapter now. Children, is my signal weak today? I can feel that my video is getting paused. Is it so?
No, ma'am.
Is it fine before?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
It is fine.
Okay. But I can feel myself getting paused after every few seconds. I don't know why.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You are pausing.
I am pausing, no? There is some problem today?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Am I absolutely clear? The video is flowing very smooth.
Ma'am, your voice stopping? Is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
My voice
ma'am,
is clear.
Ma'am, your voice is clear.
But my video isn't clear, no? My video is taking a pause.
Yes, ma'am. No, your ma'am. Video
ma'am,
is
your video is clear and voice is also clear.
Okay. But in my laptop, I can see myself getting paused. After every 5 seconds, I'm being paused. Okay. Anyways. Now, let's, a few more important lines to be underlined in this paragraph. The state has many important industries like automobiles, textiles, and electronics. The Indian film industry, Bollywood, is in Mumbai. Okay, underline all of them. Done? Now let's come on to the state of Karnataka. Who will read the state? Yes, Adeshika, read. Read out bit.
Ma'am, I just welcome.
Yes, read.
Okay, ma'am. Karnataka lies to the south of Maharashtra. Bengaluru is the capital. Other important towns are Mysore, Hubli, and Bijapur. The rivers Krishna and the Kaveri flow through the state. Teak and sandalwood trees grow in abundance. Many products are made from them. Farmers grow cotton, sugarcane, coffee, and spices. Bengaluru is the hub of software and IT industry. There are many other industries like aircraft manufacturing, electric, goods, and automobiles. The language is spoken in Canada. The tourist attractions are Mysore Palace, Vrindavan Garden, Jog Falls, as well as many temples. Dussehra and Yugadi are the popular festivals of the state.
Very nice. Now Karnataka lies to the south of which state? Maharashtra. Bengaluru is the capital. Underline it. Bengaluru is the capital. And other important towns are Mysore, Hubli, and Bijapur. What are the other important towns? They are Mysore, Hubli, and Bijapur.
Hubli and Bijapur.
Bengaluru is the hub. Now in next paragraph, Bengaluru is the hub of software and IT industries. There are many industries like, underline all of them. Aircraft manufacturing. Then, read out.
Then
electronic goods and automobiles. And then the Dussehra and Ugadi are the popular festivals of this state.
Are the important festival?
Okay, done.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. All right. Then coming next to the state of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Who will read out? Krishav, okay, try. Krishav, once more. Just try.
I'm Madhya Pradesh and Telangana.
Where are you? Huh? Andhra Pradesh. It's Andhra. Is it Madhya Pradesh, beta? Just read.
The states of Andhra Pradesh was divided into two states, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. The state is capital of Hyderabad. For both states, the river Krishna and Godavari flow through the regions of Nagrina. Dam is built on the river Krishna. The crop grown to are cotton, guar, and groundnuts and